Hari Om. In the epic Mahabharata, great warriors like Arjuna, Karna, Ashwatthama could use astras and shastras by chanting mantras. Could one really get a weapon like that?
You know, in every age, people dream about extraordinary powers. You know, we have all these comics like Superman, Batman, Spider-Man. And each of these have one special power. And some of these people have special weapons that they can use. Now, similarly, our ancient poets, remember the only weapons that they had with them in those days were actually spears and maces and bows and arrows. Only a very ancient weapon, that's all they had. They didn't have any of the modern weapons. And therefore, in their mind, when you talk of a super weapon, it's actually taking whatever they have and giving it supernatural powers. That's all they could really think of. And that's what we also actually have. When we think of actually great modern weapons, so we can only imagine things in terms of what we see. So the ancients actually, when they thought of superpowers, when their enemies were coming at them, and they didn't know what to do, they had to defeat the enemies. They wished they had superpowers. And the only superpower they had was actually loading these arrows with superpowers. So that's why they talked of arrows, you know, the Agni Astra, the Astra that will have water. And so when you shoot the Agni Astra, you shoot another arrow which will pour water on the fire. So you have arrows and you have counter arrows, which will actually neutralize the arrow that the enemy is throwing at you. In fact, after some time, people started talking about weapons which had no real counteraction. They said, okay, the Brahmastra has no counteraction. Once you hit the Brahmastra, you have to be tied and be there till somebody comes and releases, some god comes and releases you. You know, there's something called Shapa in Indian things, you know, where a rishi will go and say, may you become a serpent, may you live 10,000 years, or whatever, you know, some kind of shapa. The shapas are actually the outpourings or the unhappiness of people who had no real power. One thing to remember is that people of the period are people like us. They ate, they drank, they sang, they danced, they loved each other. And of course, they did not know, that is very important, they did not know that they were living in a Vedic age. They were living in their own age. So it's only now that they say, oh, they lived in a Vedic age. You know, people 2,000 years from now will maybe call us early computer age or something, you know, or starting computer age, something like that, which is what we are actually now.